رمضان هل هلاله وظلاله وجماله،
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Another beautiful day in the month of Ramadan. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this lovely day. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our health. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our suhoor. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ability to see another day of fasting. You are watching Soul Food on ITV with your host Maulana Zakaria Philander. Alhamdulillah, all praise is due to Allah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah, and peace and salutations upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this beautiful iman that he had given us, and we are always thankful and grateful that he had made us of those who recognize his unity, who recognize that there is none worthy of worship except him. And we pray and we make dua unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we be of those who live this iman, who are true to what we are saying, and that the last words on our lips must be la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, and that when we are resurrected on the day of reckoning, and then when we approach Allah, that we must approach him with iman, and that when we are given entrance into Jannah, we must be given entrance because of the being the mu'mineen and the muttaqeen, and that we must enter to Jannah through the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What a lovely opportunity is the month of Ramadan to develop a relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have relationships of various kinds. We have relationships with our spouses, with our children, with our colleagues, with our friends, and so on and so forth. But what is the most important relationship in the life of a believer? That relationship that will never leave you, that relationship that will never die, that relationship that will never disappoint, that is the relationship that the slave needs to have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this morning I want to focus on that relationship. How do we nurture that relationship? How do we develop that relationship? How do we gain proximity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? For if we claim to truly be believers, then we must be interested in nurturing that relationship. Do we not nurture relationships with those who we love? Do we not nurture relationships with those who we care about? Subhanallah, yes we do. We invest a lot of time, we invest a lot of effort, we invest a lot of dedication to see to it that our interpersonal relationship is of a good quality. But how much time, how much dedication do we put into nurturing a relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So this morning, I would like to discuss some important points in nurturing your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're going to try to be very practical about it so that in this month of Ramadan, you can take this advice and you can take it seriously towards working towards a close relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's start off by mentioning one of the ways of gaining closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want to be in a relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you need to gain proximity to Him. You need to gain closeness to Him. And one of the ways to gain proximity, there are many ways, but the way we are going to choose this morning to highlight is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. That verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is with those who are patient. And here the operative word is ma'a, ma'iyya. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He is with those who are patient, subhanallah. What is patience? Patience is the ability to do what you need to do, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requires of you to do, and to be patient and to go about doing it constantly, being patient in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, being patient in staying away from wrongdoing. Day in and day out, even though shaitan tempts you, day in, day out, you are persevering with patience that you will stay away from that which shaitan is calling you towards, from the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Showing patience when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test you with any type of calamity or with any type of affliction in your life. If you are of those who work hard to establishing patience, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be with you, because you will have the rank of those who are patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in the Quran, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. And give glad tidings and give good news to those who are patient. Subhanallah. So here we find one of the most effective ways of gaining proximity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is patience. And to summarize, what type of patience? Patience firstly in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Go back to your salah time after time after time. Protect your tongue from saying the wrong words time after time after time. Think good of your Muslim brother, do good. Do it time after time after time. Persevere with patience. Go back to the recitation of Quran every day. Go back to listening to the advices of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam every day, and you will be written amongst the patient, insha'Allah. And because of that, you will gain proximity and you will gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, in further on in nurturing your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the practical advices that I want to share with you this morning is that you should be of those who do not hesitate when it comes to doing good. When it comes to any type of good, whether it is ibadah, meaning an act of worship, or whether it is an act where you're going to extend yourself to humanity, which in fact is also an act of worship, like feeding the poor, looking after the orphan, looking after the homeless, so on and so forth. All of these things, when the opportunity comes and when the opportunity arises, you should hasten towards that opportunity, subhanallah. Because the people who hasten to the opportunity, they are the people who have a special rank and special privilege by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَالسَّابِقُونَ السَّابِقُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ الْمُقَرَّبُونَ. The ones who hasten, the ones who are foremost, the one who race to do good, the one who race to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أُولَٰئِكَ الْمُقَرَّبُونَ. Those are the ones who are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. So don't be second, be first. If there's an opportunity to give charity, don't hesitate, give the charity. If there's an opportunity to give good advice, don't hesitate, give the good advice. If there's an opportunity to take good advice, be the first to take that good advice, inshallah, and then you will be written amongst the muqarrabun. You will be written amongst the close ones. You will be written amongst the foremost ones, amongst the excited and eager ones who are always close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After the break, we'll go further discussing some important aspects to develop our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Stay tuned. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. You're watching Soul Food on ITV with myself, Maulana Zakaria Philander. This morning we're talking about developing a relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is a relationship of meaning, a meaningful relationship. And already we have given two practical advices. The first is the practicing of patience, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allaha ma'a sabireen, that verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with the ones who are patient. So you will gain proximity, you will gain nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through being from amongst the sabireen. The second one that we spoke about was, be of those who hasten to do good deeds. They hasten towards iman, and they hasten towards the implications of iman. And what is the implications of iman? It is to do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had commanded you to do. But not only do you do it, you do it with eagerness, you do it with earnestness, and you do it without flinching, and you do it without thinking. You dive straight into the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you do that, you will be written amongst the muqarrabun, amongst those special slaves whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala draws close. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. there's going to be a time in our lives where we're going to wish that we are of those who are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me remind you, because reminder is beneficial for a believer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Waqi'ah, فَلَوْلَا إِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْكُومِ وَأَنْتُمْ حِينَ إِذٍ تَنْظُرُونَ, that when at that time, that when the ruh, when it is going to reach the throat, وَأَنْتُمْ حِينَ إِذٍ تَنْظُرُونَ, and you are looking and you are witnessing and you are seeing that this person is about to die, وَأَنْتُمْ حِينَ إِذٍ تَنْظُرُونَ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْكُمْ وَلَكِنْ لَا تُبْصِرُونَ, and Allah says, and we are closer to them but you do not perceive. فَلَوْلَا إِن كُنْتُمْ غَيْرَ مَدِينِينَ تَرْجِعُونَهَا إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. You see this ruh coming out, if you have any authority, if you have any power, then try to take the soul and try to put it back in so that this person doesn't die. إِن كُنْتُمْ تَرْجِعُونَهَا إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Allahu Akbar. Who has the ability at the time of death, that when the soul is pulled and when the soul comes out, to put that soul back? But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, at that time, there is a special group of people. فَأَمَّا إِن كَانَ مِنَ الْمُقَرَّبِينَ. But as for those who are the close ones, and we spoke about the close ones now and how to gain proximity, as for those who are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at that time, فَرَوْحٌ وَرَيْحَانٌ, they will have rest at that time. وَرَيْحَانٌ, they will have provisions at that time. وَجَنَّةُ نَعِيمٌ, and they will have gardens of bliss at that time. Allahu Akbar. While for the rest of us it will seem like the harsh reality and the painful reality of death is setting in on this individual, because they are of the مُقَرَّبُونَ, because they are of those who are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They nurtured their relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At that time Allah will give them rest. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant them provisions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant them the fragrance of Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show them their Jannah. Allahu Akbar. It is worth the effort. It is worth the time. It is worth the effort that we engage in developing our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How much time do we spend on other things? How much time do we spend on useless activities? How much time do we spend sometimes on useless relationships that will bring us nothing? In vain talk, in idle talk, subhanallah. Utilize those moments in the obedience of Allah. Utilize those moments in developing a relationship with Allah. Speak to Allah. Speak to Allah through the recitation of the Quran. Speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through your salah, and then you will see. Speak to Allah also subhanahu wa ta'ala also through your adhkar. Then you will see that relationship is being nurtured, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you special gifts. Another aspect in developing our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that we should actually do good deeds. And this sounds so simple, but yes, it is not only the doing of good deeds. When you do good deeds, you are actually gaining proximity. You are actually working on your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Isn't it that when you do something of good and it benefits man, that man feels that you are close to them, that man feels that you are a benefit to them, and that you become beloved to man? Subhanallah. What about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيءُ أَجْرَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not waste any good deed. No good deed goes to waste when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but He will reward. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Verily, those who believe and who do good deeds. So engage in good deeds, especially in this month of Ramadan. And when we talk about good deeds, especially go in the service of humanity. Serve the marginalized. Go in the service of those who are having difficulty in their lives. Those who are poor. Those who are needy. Those who are living on the fringes of society. The women who their husbands have died. The orphan child, subhanallah. Those who have been displaced. Refugees, subhanallah. Those people who are have no hope of ever returning to their countries. Those people who find themselves in constraints, those people who had lost all their wealth and they are living on the streets, subhanallah, those are the people that you must seek out. For if you seek them out, you will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by them. Seek out the sick, seek out those who are struggling, seek out those who are in pain, and you be the one to help them. You be the one to offer assistance, and in your assistance and in your offering to help, you will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ. They are those that they feed the people out of love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you must do these good deeds, all these good deeds that we are talking about. You do it for no reward other than for receiving the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't want anything from man. Allah says they feed because they love Allah. They feed the miskeena wa yateema wa asira. They are in the service of the poor. They are in the service of the orphan. They are in the service of those who are imprisoned. And they say, إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. Indeed, we are in their service. We are helping them. We are feeding them in order that we gain Allah. We want Allah. We are doing it sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءُ وَلَا شُكُورًا. And they tell the people, we do not want from you any reward. We are doing this thing, but we want nothing from you in return. Don't even mention it. Don't mention our names. Don't mention it to other people. وَلَا شُكُورًا. Don't even give us thanks, because all thanks is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After the break, we'll come back with more useful tips on developing our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll be back after this. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Welcome back. You're watching Soul Food on ITV, and we are talking about developing our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last point that we made before the break was the importance of doing good deeds, the importance of being in the service of humanity. And once you find yourself in the service of humanity, non-judgmental, we don't judge. Judging is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We serve. We serve irrespective of race. We serve irrespective of religion. We serve irrespective of creed. We serve irrespective of geographical boundaries. We serve only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La nuridu minkum jaza'u wa la shukura. And we do not want any thanks from anyone. And we do not want any praise. And we do not want any reward from anyone. Because we must do it solely for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what ikhlas is about. And this is what sincerity is about. Lillah. You do it for Allah. Remember that. Whenever you do anything, when you go about your entire day, always think, Lillah. I'm doing this for Allah. Even your fasting. Your fasting is Lillah. It is for Allah. When you go for Hajj, you make niyyah for Hajj. Nawaitul Hajj. Lillah. Nawaitul Umrah. I intend Umrah. Lillah. Nawaitul Salatul Maghrib. Lillah. Nawaitul Salatul Fajr. Lillah. Everything that you do for Allah. I intend to serve humanity for Allah. And in that way, you will become the friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will become your protector. And you will be in a close, intimate relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that no man can take away from you. Another important aspect in developing our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and gaining proximity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and gaining the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. If you want to gain the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, adopt the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Adopt the consciousness. Walk around every moment, every day, knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking at you. Go through your day even as if you are witnessing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are unable to do that, then know that in every act that you are engaging in, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. And that is the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this should lead you, this knowledge, this mindfulness, this consciousness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always there, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is constantly there, should lead you to be the best human being that you could possibly be. It should lead you to be the best husband. It should lead you to be the best wife. It should lead you to be the best child, the best son, the best daughter, the best worker, the best colleague, the best employer, the best employee. Everything solely because you know that you are going to be held accountable by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if this is your approach to life, that you have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show mercy on you. Allahu Akbar. Are we not in need of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us the formula of drawing the mercy. Subhanallah, we don't just raise our hands and say, Ya Allah, have mercy on us, have mercy on us, have mercy on us. But we go about our lives willy-nilly, doing what we want to do, how we want to do it, with whomever we want to do. Subhanallah, this is not the way of a believer. This is not the way of the muttaqeen. The muttaqeen are those who, they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is the month of Ramadan, what it is about. It is a month about developing taqwa. And if you develop that taqwa, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ, not only is it going to help your relationship that Allah is going to show mercy on you, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهُ, adopt the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make learning easy for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will teach you. You will understand the ways of the world. You will understand the ways of humanity. You will understand the ways of the heart. You will understand the way to reach closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All you need to do is to develop that taqwa. And the month of Ramadan is that month to do it. Subhanallah. Have taqwa and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show you mercy. Another way to get the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is important for your relationship with Allah, because who doesn't want the mercy of Allah? The important way is Ar-Rahimun Yarhamuhumur Rahman. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, Ar-Rahimun, those who show mercy, Yarhamuhumur Rahman. The one who is most merciful will show mercy to you. Allahu Akbar. Another formula, another secret that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is sharing with us. It's no longer a secret. It is on offer for everyone. You want to gain Allah's mercy? You find yourself in constraints? You find yourself in difficulty? You require His mercy? You be merciful, subhanallah. You be merciful and you will find the one who is most merciful is going to share His mercy and shower you with His mercy. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had advised, Irhamu man fil ard. Be merciful with whomsoever is in this earth. Allahu Akbar. What a beautiful deen is this deen of Islam. Be merciful with everyone and with everything. Allahu Akbar. This includes all of humanity and it includes everything in the animal kingdom. Subhanallah. And it includes everything in nature. If you don't have to break a plant, if you don't have to pluck a leaf, if you don't have to move a stone from its rightful place, then don't do it, because that shows the mercy that you have towards even the nature that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had created around you. And if you have that level of mercy, يَرْحَمُكُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ, says the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then the one who is in the heavens is going to have mercy on you. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who have mercy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those whom He showers His mercy on them. We make dua that these advices that we have given this morning to develop closeness with Allah, to develop a relationship with Allah, that we practice on these advices, that it become practical in our lives, and that we are going to see the benefits and the fruits starting right now. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.